All right. Thank you, folks. All right. Let me be the first to welcome you to the annual Michael H. Freitag Data Visualization Competition Winners Presentation. That is a mouthful. We are very excited to highlight our eight grand prize winners of this annual competition. Today, we'll be hearing from four of our grand prize winners, and tomorrow at the same time, we'll be hearing from the remaining four of our grand prize winners. I'm not going to say much about Mike Freilich at this point because we have two representatives from NASA and AGU that are going to do a bang-up job about that. So without further ado, I'd like to invite up Steve Platnick from NASA to give some opening remarks.
Thank you, Steve. Good afternoon. How is everybody? Doing well? Well, I'm real excited to be here. My name's Steve Platnick. I'm an Earth Scientist at the NASA Goddard Space Flight Center, so that's just up the road from here. And I've had the pleasure since the inception of this competition to be involved in the grant that NASA provides to AGU. So AGU organizes and manages this entire activity, and we're very grateful for this work that we do with them. A little background on this. This is the ninth year of doing this competition. And we first started it out, it was a fairly small effort, and we mainly focused on Earth science. We'll get to Michael Freilich in just a second. But since then, we've expanded so it includes all the sciences being represented at AGU. And as a longtime attendee of AGU, and it goes back three decades now, I have to say, it really means a lot to me that AGU and NASA are continuing with this relationship. Let me say a little bit about Michael Freilich now. Sorry about that. Michael was the head of the NASA Earth Science Division starting in 2006 until his retirement in 2019, excuse me. So it was a remarkable, a 13-year run, which it's a tough position, and it's remarkable that he was in that position and how much impact he had on all of us. And one of the things that Michael was very good about was reaching out and having communication, not just with the science community, but also with students. And part of that involves probably the inspiration or the efforts he's had for students in the past. He was a professor at Oregon State before he then came to NASA, but was also involved in some NASA projects. And sadly, Michael passed away in 2020, and this competition was named in his honor. And I think it's really fitting that we renamed it for Michael because, like many of us, he was here from the start at the beginning of this competition 9 years ago. He helped support and provide encouragement for that. And in many ways, we're here today because of what Michael did for us. So if you look at some of these slides up here, I hope you can at least capture a little bit about who Michael was, what he meant to all of us, and how he contributed to us being here today. With that, I'm excited to see these talks. We have from AGU, Kristen Averitt, who is the Executive Vice President for Science.
Thank you so much, Steve. So it's an absolute pleasure to be here today to recognize the winners of the Freilich Award. Congratulations to all of you. You know, as you were speaking, since 2016, 60 different people have actually been awardees. And those folks have gone on to do some pretty fantastic things. They're working at the cutting edge of technology. We have some that actually have ended up at NASA, as I understand. And then we have some that are working in science communication and education. And I think what you all are doing, you're really, really recognizing Freilich's vision, which was about ensuring that students are at the cutting edge of visualization and telling stories about science. Because one of the best ways to communicate our science is to tell a story about it. So it's really an honor to be here and to recognize all of the fine work that you have done. Congratulations, and thank you once again.
Thank you, Steve, and thank you, Kristen. At this point, before we get started with our first Hyperwell talk, I would like to invite the students up to be recognized and to receive a gift. So first up, I'd like to invite Dylan Wooten to the stage. Where's Dylan? Yep, there you go. There's Dylan. All right. Next, Jorge Bravo. Come on. Yep, perfect. Caitlin Heydrich. And last but not least, Patrick Kerwin. Congratulations to you all.